One can gaze upon something and see the wonder in it. Two can gaze together and share that wonder. We are forever emitting sparks of imagination. So, let's spark together. In every mind is a piece of code that operates our creative functions. It forms a conduit called the cerebrumbilical cord that extends to the farthest reaches of imagination. So let's build. Together we can push back the boundaries until they are a mere speck on the stellar horizon. Let's fly. Let's put our minds together and create. Everyone on this orb of dreamers contributes ideas. They ascend the cerebrumbilical cord to congregate in the imagisphere, the natural home of our creative wanderings. So join us, for you have always been and always will be most welcome in Little Big Planet. The imagisphere. Now, I know you're eager to get stuck into all this, but please remember the ethos of the imagisphere. Create and share and above all...
Yes. Thanks for that, old man. I'll take it from here. Oh, what luck. There's my little chum-to-be ready to come and help me sort out Bunkum. Just a simple press of this button and our adventure will begin.
So... one on the left. No, but if I'm facing it, then that would be on the...
Oh, that's the one! Old chap, my name's Newton. Welcome to Bunkum Chummy Chum Chum, where the sky is strewn with circling clouds of imagination, all ceaselessly pumped into Bunkum's atmosphere by the pounding creative heart at its core, a magnificent moon of wonder. But I'm afraid Bunkum's destiny lies in our hands. Let me explain. Long ago, before the Negativitron nearly laid waste a craft world, three gluttonous gargoyles gorged on Bunkum's bountiful creativity. Inspiration dried up. We teetered on the brink of the abyss. And then three heroes came. With their speed, with their power, with their grace, they finally managed to capture the Titans. With Bunkum restored to the creative paradise you see around you, the heroes retired to the pages of myth. A myth that also foretells of the return of the Titans. Tonight, just before bedtime, all of Bunkum's nightmares become real. And that's where we come in. Join me, my noble assistant. Buncombe's very future depends on we two brave heroes. Now, we must retire to my airship to prepare for your, our death-defying mission. Look at us, co-conspirators, primed for our first top-secret mission briefing. Here, take this sticker. That is our first target. A loathsome locale called Stitcher
Within
Manor.
Those walls lurks
a cranky old bag named Nana Pud. Put her face up there if you could stomach it. Gruesome. But we must brave her horrors and make our way up onto the roof. One last sticker. Place it down there, if you would. That is our true goal. The tin that houses the evil Titan. We must reach it before Nana Pud releases them. The old bag. Fortunately, I've handcrafted something for just this occasion. Going down. Here we are. Activate those switches and we'll be on our way. Brilliant. Join me in this super vertical infiltration station. And to Stitcher Manor we go! Not a great victory for health and safety, but a thrilling ride nonetheless. This, old chum, is Stitcher Manor, the final resting place of those dreaded titans. Nana Pud, the crazy crone who lives here, I suspect to be the prophetic liberator of those diabolical denizens. That means she's going to release them. You must get up there and stop her. Me? Oh, well, I've got eggs to boil. But rest assured, I'll be right behind you. Well, not right behind you. Give you a bit of space, obviously. But safely behind you. Pip, pip.
Newty! I might have known this was something to do with you. You can't trust a word this boy says. He's tricked you. And he was such a lovely baby.
Oh, come on, Mumsy. It's time they were released. Imagine what we can do with all that creativity.
Never. Don't you remember what your father said? You must never, ever... open the lid! You fool! What have you done? Buncombe will be ruined!
No, with the Titans under our control, we can make Buncombe the happiest, jolliest picnic spot in the whole Imagisphere. And I couldn't have done it without you, old chum. Come, Titans, let us make Buncombe, Buncombe! Sorry, Buncombe. Slight change of plan. I think I will destroy you instead. Farewell, dear friend.
My Newty astray. Poor Newty. He never done no one no harm. He don't know no better. You got to save him from himself. And on the way, you'll save Buncombe too. Come on, follow me. You can't defeat the Titans by yourself. You. I've seen more muscle on a jelly deal. You'll need to awaken Buncombe's old heroes. Otsock, Toggle and Swoop. It won't be easy, but your quest begins in Manglewood, Buncombe's great swamp. So this is Manglewood. This filthy swamp was once home to Buncombe's thriving film industry. Have a word with Marlon Random. He's gone a bit bonkers, but he knows what's what. With Otsock on your side, you can stop those horrible Titans and bring back my Newty.
Winning smile. Dramatic pause. Marlon Random is the name. Method acting is the game. Come on, baby, bring it closer. Closer. That's it. Beautiful! Camera never lies. How you doing, Cloth Kid? Looking for Oddsock, huh? Well, you're gonna need to find Oddsock's three marbles first. When the Titans were defeated, the great heroes lost their motivation. Soon, they lost their marbles, too. And retreated into their sanctuaries. They haven't been seen since. Over time, the marbles were forgotten by all but Buncombe's oldest and wisest. And coolest. Lucky for you, old Marlon Random knows where they are. One's in the heavily guarded fort. We're gonna have to do that one real quiet-like. One is in the dark heart of the Imagisphere. One sits in the boughs of a great tree. You need to branch out to find it. When you find a marble, it will fly back to its place on the shrine gate. Find all three, and the gate will open. Don't worry, kid. I'll be on hand to direct you. Nice work, kid. Just step through the door to meet Oddsock. Nice work, kid. Just step through the door to meet Oddsock. Wow. The set for Pinballs in the Mist. What a classic.
Careful where you step. You never know what lurks behind the scenes.
What was that?
Anyone there? Back off. I played someone who knew karate.
Wait, is it...
Yes, yes, it is! May I present, star of stage and screen, Oddsock! Oddsock, let me introduce you to Cloth Kid.
Look at you two. Natural co-stars.
What chemistry.
We better roll. This place isn't safe.
Yeah.
Look out!
That was not in the script. Thankfully, I'm a master of improvisation.
Cloth Kid! You head back to the swamp. We'll see you up there.
Well, ready to step back into the limelight?
Ah, the farewell scene. Always a tear-jerker.
But go you must. Take the bridge to the ziggurat. There you'll find your next co-star. The mighty Toggle. You can change characters here, kid. It's any actor's dream.
Next stop for you is the ziggurat, where Toggle is waiting.
That kid can act. Big parts, small parts. He's got it all.
Dear friend. Out walking the dog, I see. How am I? Well, actually, I'm well on my way to becoming the Imagisphere's greatest creator. Thanks for asking. True, it means there's nothing left for anybody else, but that's a small price to pay, wouldn't you agree? Oh. But I see you don't. Such a shame our friendship has to end this way.
Thank you.
Onslaught, what a comeback! 5 stars! That's one act in the can, and 2 to go. The second hero is shacked up somewhere in the ziggurat,
Bunkum's great temple of creativity.
This will take you straight there. Papier-mâché, the ziggurat's chief dude, will help you on your quest. Tell him if he does, I'll give him an autograph!
Come, Brain, don't be like this. Let us make friends again.
Greetings, unusual one. Papier-mâché is my name, and this place is the Ziggurat, my finest creation. Once, people of Ziggurat were filled with ideas. Fisher people of Imagisphere. Then, the Newton came, and everything changed. I changed. Now, when I open my mouth, there is no dreaming, no sparkle. Just big hairy brain turkey. Anyway, only hope now is that Toggle, second hero of the Bunkum, will come back and return Ziggurat to top of charts. For this, we need your help, strange little silent person. The doors to resting place of Toggle are sealed closed, can only be broken by 3 marbles. Marbles are scattered all over Ziggurat. I had clever method of getting them back quickly, but in my mind now is only windmills and vinegar. Anyway, so I am afraid it is long way around for you. One is an enormous burning house of flames. So hot, so sweaty. Another lost somewhere in a labyrinth. Final marble is being used as eye for mechanical dragon. Not most practical idea, but still very creative, no? Bring all 3 marbles to this statue and Toggle will be without the marbles. The resurrection of Toggle cannot take place. My heart, it fills with such joy. Now, last marble is in place and soon Toggle will return. Ziggurat will be restored. No more hairy brain turkey, instead, great sparkle of inspiration! Three marbles! Toggle's awakening is upon us! Enter doorway to meet legendary hero of the Bunkum. The Newton. Oh, my thought train has left without me. What was I saying? Ah, yes. Ballet dancers. Tiptoeing through the world. Leaving lightest of footprints. Truly, most graceful creatures we know. Speak of the Toggle. You look same as ever. So, how is little one? A face full of attitude still, huh?
Perhaps you could blow up cobwebs with a little demonstration.
Marvelous.
Come now to Ziggurat. I will explain everything. There we have it. Excellent digging. Watch out! Well, this, I guess, is big problem. But no problem for mighty Toggle. Ha! We see you back at Ziggurat in 2 jiffies. Toggle is awakened. Last hero, Swoop, is in Bankam Lagoon. Take elevator to find, yes? Or explore Ziggurat as Toggle. I mind not.
Friend, how marvelous to see you. How galling it must be for you to see how creative I've become. But this is just the beginning, dear chums. The creative heart now belongs to me. Yes, me! All of Bunkum's thoughts and dreams are mine to do with as I please. And who is this? Another of Bunkum's has-been heroes? Well, you've seen better days, haven't you? It matters not. You cannot stop me now. You'll have to excuse me. I have affairs of the heart to attend to.
Silent friend, I knew you could do it. The Titans, they promise quick road, but like angry chicken, they cannot be controlled. They play the Newton like a puppet. Titans, that is, not chicken. You must find and defeat Third Titan before time runs out for all of us. Take lift to Bankam Lagoon and awake Swoop. Only together can you stop the Newton. Before he makes bad decision, like, I don't know, big fortress shaped like face or something. With heart under the Newton's control, all creativity in Bankam trapped like hamster in ball. Good luck! Oh,
blast my mind open. I forgot most important thing. Buy me funny souvenir hat, if you have the time.
That Newton. I will smash his tiny bulb into a million teeny pieces and trample on every one. And you will be next. I will pick you apart stitch by stitch and make you into a nice scarf. Or a hat. What is happening to me? First, the heart was lost. Now, my temper. I am Pinky, the great queen of Buncombe Lagoon, protector of the creative heart, which has been lost to that purple ninny. Until it is restored, I am angrier than a typhoon in a jam jar. First, you must find Swoop's missing marbles. One is at the top of a towering tower, and the other is in the belly of a monstrous monster. Send them both back here, and we can awaken that lazy old bird, Swoop. Was not enough for you. You would survive if I pushed you off. No, Buncombe's heroes will soon be reunited. I must maintain my royal composure. After all, we're finally on track for a happy ending.
How right you are. A perfect day for target practice. Fools!
Head back to the lagoon while Swoop and I give him the slip. I will be displeased if you've forgotten your fancy flapwork, bird. Let's go!
How could I, the Imagisphere's finest creator, hope to outwit a team of peerless heroes? Oh, I feel a deep woe inside my breast. If only Papa was here to comfort me. I planned to become the ultimate creator. I can see now that I was wrong. Because I was always better than you. You and your bunkum chums can't hold a candle to my creative genius. Back off. You wouldn't want your little chum to get vaporized, would you? And don't try and stop me, you cloth-eared fools. This fortress is impregnable. I designed it myself. Bunkum silent heroes helping their fallen leader. But it won't do you any good. You will all fall here together.
Nothing. You're nothing. All you are is a big embarrassment. Ooh, look at me. I'm Newton. Everything I make turns out rubbish.
What? No, no, it doesn't.
My dad's a legend. I'm an incompetent oink.
No, no, I'm not.
I call people my friends, but they laugh at me behind my back.
No, they do. Do they? Do people really laugh at me?
Take a look in the mirror. What do you think?
I think that you, my friend, are a big blooming bully, and I'm not going to stand here and listen to this any longer. I mean, really, in this day and age, people like you should be... Oh,
that was easier than I thought it would be.
Go team me! Oh, what's going on? I feel weird. What have I done?
Your own size. The trick, you see, is to show no fear.
Okay, I'm a little bit afraid now.
Thank you.
We need to get out of here, quick! I'm allergic to drowning! I come out in these big... well, death.
What did I say about the Titans, Newton?
I don't remember there being a strict rule.
Newton! We'll continue this at home. Come, let us return to Stitcher Manor. Should hold them. Buncombe is forever in your debt, as too am I, on behalf of my slim-witted son. Now, Newton, how are you getting on with that dimensional doorway?
As good as new! You sure you don't want me to come with you all? I'm sure I'd be a great help. I know a few jokes. Well, I hope Craftworld is ready for the four of you. I ably navigated the belly of the beast before planting an explosive device.
So, dear little big Planetian, as Newton tries in vain to rewrite the events we have just witnessed with our own peepers, we say farewell to our brave band of friends, heroes who worked together to put things right. We saw one become several, bonded together in the noble crusade of creating and sharing. And we were reminded there are so many like-minded thinkers up here, sailing the ever-expanding astral tides of the imagisphere. Every one of us emits thoughts, notions, and dreams, and by connecting with others, we can make a better reality in this, our own world. This celestial plane of potential, this stellar collective of wide-eyed wanderers and wanderers, this little big planet.